Good evening, and a very warm welcome to our Christmas concert broadcast. For those of you who don't already know me, my name is Debbie Madden, and I'm the Director of Music at King Edward VI School. I'm delighted that you have joined us to enjoy the highlights of this term's extracurricular music. We have worked hard to promote a positive outlook on the current restrictions, and are particularly grateful to visiting music teachers Mrs. Powell-Brett, Miss Mills and Mrs. Pugh for standing in for students who were unexpectedly absent on our recording days. Also to the school's pound a day scheme, which meant that a contribution to the cost of a new digital piano for use in the chapel was possible, as sadly the organ is currently out of action. And to staff and students who have adapted superbly to the challenges of playing and singing far more spaced out than normal. There has been plenty to celebrate, from rehearsing our Year 7 soloists for the first verse of Once in Royal David City, to recording the concerto movement used for a Year 13 Music College audition. We have worked with changing voices in Year 9, welcomed some fantastic new students into Year 12, and a lot more besides. It has been varied and exciting. In normal years, the service of nine lessons and carols is one of the highlights of the school calendar. We recreate a shortened version of this in the second half of our concert here in the Guild Chapel. And we invite you to join us in singing the carols at home. We start by going over to the Levi Foxhall for a range of ensembles and sixth form soloists.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Tiger by William Blake. Tiger, tiger, burning bright in the forests of the night, what immortal hand or eye could frame thy fearful symmetry? In what distant deeps or skies burnt the fire of thine eyes? On what wings dare he aspire? What the hand dare seize the fire? And what shoulder and what heart could twist the sinews of thy heart? And when thy heart began to beat, what dread hand and what dread feet? What the hammer, what the chain? In what furnace was thy brain? What the anvil, what dread grasp dare its deadly terrors clasp? When the stars threw down their spears and watered heaven with their tears, did he smile his work to see? Did he who made the lamb make thee? Tiger, tiger, burning bright in the forests of the night, what immortal hand or eye dare frame thy fearful symmetry?
The Lamb by William Blake. Little lamb, who made thee? Dost thou know who made thee? Gave thee life and bid thee feed by the stream and o'er the mead. Gave thee clothing of delight, softest clothing, woolly, bright. Gave thee such a tender voice, making all the vales rejoice. Little lamb, who made thee? Dost thou know who made thee? Little lamb, I'll tell thee. Little lamb, I'll tell thee. He is called by thy name, for he calls himself a lamb. He is meek and he is mild. He became a little child. I a child and thou a lamb. We are called by his name. Little lamb, God bless thee. Little lamb, God bless thee.
Thank you. Shepherd's Calendar by Norman Nicholson. Three practical farmers from back of the day, under the high sky, on a Saturday night said so long to their sheep that were bottom of dyke and fast asleep when the stars came out in the Christmas sky. They called at the pub for a gill of ale under the high sky, and they found in the stable, stacked with the corn, the latest arrival newly born, when the stars came out in the Christmas sky. They forgot their drink, they rubbed their eyes under the high sky. They were tough as leather and ripe as a cheese, but they dropped like a 10-year-old down on their knees when the stars came out in the Christmas sky. They ran out in the yard to swap their news under the high sky. They pulled off their caps and they roused a cheer to greet a spring lamb before the new year when the stars came out in the Christmas sky.
Thank you.
Saint Bridget of Sweden, Revelations. When I was present by the manger of the Lord in Bethlehem, I beheld a virgin of extreme beauty, well wrapped in a white mantle and a delicate tunic, through which I clearly perceived her virgin body. With her was an old man of great honesty, and they brought with them an ox and ass. These entered the cave, and the man, after having tied them to the manger, went outside and brought to the Virgin a burning candle, and having attached this to the wall, he went outside again so that he might not be present at the birth. Then the Virgin pulled off the shoes from her feet, drew off the white mantle that enveloped her, removed the veil from her head, laying it by her side, thus remaining in her tunic alone, with her beautiful golden hair falling loosely over her shoulders. Then she produced two small linen cloths and two woolen ones of exquisite purity and fineness, which she had brought to wrap up the child who was to be born, and two other small pieces with which to cover and bind his head. And these she then sat down on the ground, laying the child on her lap, and at once she began to bestow on him much care, tying up his small body, his legs and arms with long cloths. Then she enveloped the head of the child in two linen garments prepared for the purpose. And when this was done, the old man entered, and prostrating himself on the floor, he wept for joy. And in no way was the Virgin changed by birth, neither as to the colour of her face, nor as to any illness, and her bodily strength did not decline, as is usually the case with women when they bear. But then she stood up, and together the two, that is, herself and Joseph, put him in the manger, and on their knees worshipped him with immense joy until the arrival of the kings. And the kings recognized the son from his likeness to his mother.
Thank you. 2 to 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shone. You have multiplied the nation, you have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of the oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.